Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Nick of today, playing some Timmer and Stone, Land of Islay, Season 3. Look at this. Fantastic. Merv's rattling around again. What a bastard. I just need to find a way to actually not hear what the fuck he's doing. Unfortunately, that would involve you not hearing my voice, which is a downside, I might add. That's sort of the point. So there we go. What did we do last episode? Well, last episode, we created ourselves this beautiful tower right here. I think this is exactly how it looked before, but what I've also done is I've created the tower on the other side and made sort of a little thing up here. And I've also replicated it on this side right here. I've also dug a moat at the back here, which I think needs to be 2 blocks lower, to be honest with you, because you can move this water. I did just test it right here, and they will move the water if you give it space to do so. So we'll need to actually make a path for the water to get down here, but unfortunately, it is 2 blocks down. If I just test it right here, like this is the water layer right here. If I just go down a level, because you can't see it here, which means it won't go that far down. There you go. So we need to go sort of like 1 or 2 blocks down to really make the moat make sense. I would rather it just sort of be right here, but I can't do that. So at some point, we will have to just finish off making this moat by going down 2 more layers. It won't be too much of a bother, but we will need to actually get it done on this side as well. What we're going to do in this episode is just sort of building the moat a little bit more. Hopefully making some sort of fishing village and getting the farm moved over here. I like the idea of doing that. And I will be trying to make the front gate. It is going to be slightly bigger. That's the whole point we've got right here. Ow, Merv, what are you doing? What are you trying to do? I'd rather you be there than shouting in your cage. Now we have run out of tools. For those that are wondering, I'm ill. So it's getting very difficult to actually talk for extended periods of time without screwing up. It's kind of normal, really. Oh, God. Also, I'll be sniffling a lot. I'll be sniffing a lot of things. It's pretty fantastic. We're really running out of space right here. This is why we need the fishing village, so we can move a bunch of crap and then use this side. This is meant to be the courtyard, okay? We're not meant to have people in here. Something that we need to get around to doing is actually making the wall around this moat. I'm not too sure if I want to make it out of wood or stone or a bit of both. Probably a bit of both, but the thing is, I like the idea of making sort of a fairly large wall around the main keep that's made out of stone. But then again, I could use wood because they can still burn the stone anyway, the necromancers. So it will not make much of a difference. We found that out during the unfortunate events of the fight that did take place. Go to super speed mode. Also, we are running out of metal space, apparently, which is interesting, because I don't remember... Oh, I guess it was all the mining they did. You know, there's a lot of materials around here that we actually go ahead and gather, which is something we may go ahead and do. Also need to designate this... Oh, apparently there was a merchant that I missed. Don't worry about it. Who cares about that guy? Right, so we'll just get this mining done here. Beautiful. I'm going to try and find out how we're going to get this sorted out. So let's see. What builders do we have at our disposal? We've got Seaboy and Jared right here. Ephril's a good miner, so I'm going to leave you to that. Radcliffe Sutton, right here, who is a new person. We have quite a lot of new people, I might add. You can definitely tell by their names that just sort of... They've got like a second name and a last... Well, they got a first name and a last name, basically. Whereas our people are generally just given one name. So we got Radcliffe Sutton right here. Got Hill Jared Goddard. Fantastic. Francis Belmont. Oh, that's a fantastic name. Francis Belmont. Yeah, 3 new people. They're sort of either I've been given while making this, which was amazing, I might add. They just kept coming in. It was awesome. But we will need to actually give name to those people eventually. None of them are lazy. Sorry, Naria. Actually, I'm not too sure if they are lazy. We should go back on the list now that I think about it. We did get someone that was lazy, but I named them already. So I didn't want to make the person feel bad. Oh, wow, Liam. So we automatically click on the lazy person. Yeah, Liam. It was someone that requested to be named, I believe. Right, so let's see. Any lazy traits? Oh, yep, Liam again. I thought he just went past you. Does not look like it. Got clumsy, but that's not what we're looking for. Yep, Liam. So we got 17 people, I might add, in our Land of Islay. Hopefully some more people come by and actually help us out. I'm not too sure if I want to mine this brick. This giant sort of slab of rock. I kind of think it would be a good idea, but I'm not too sure just yet. But I definitely want to set this up as the farm. We can probably get some sort of... I really want to get the wall set up. That's what I want to do. It's not too big, but I want to just have like 2 blocks so I know where the wall's going to be. probably have to go over this block and we'll fill that in. But still, we've got quite a lot to do over here, so maybe we're getting a little bit too ambitious. If we go on this side and actually tell them to mine a little bit more, we're going 7 blocks away from the main castle itself. Oh, that's not right. I don't know why they missed that block, but that's fine. We'll mine that block up. And it's meant to be 3 blocks down. As you can see, that's how far the actual bridge goes, which is good. It looks good. We've got to get this done as well. Right, so as I was saying until I interrupted myself, fantastic, I do that a lot. We need to get another builder because I don't think 2's enough. I think 4's a good amount. So let's see, Farkas, level 5, yeah? Well, actually, no. We'll get Goddard right here to be a builder. And we'll get... Sniper's a good miner. We'll get Radcliffe to do it. There we go. So we've got 4 builders. We're going to get them set up on this sort of slightly bigger towers that are going to be set up right here. How big are they really going to be? See, now I've tried to test this on the stream, because I did a live stream, 2 of them, on Minecraft, where I actually built the entire castle. And that's it looks pretty good, I would say. It'll probably look better on timber and stone, because it's sort of made for it. But I'm looking forward to actually building that. I'm not too sure if I'm going to get much of that done today, because I'm going to have to look back on it and then look here. So I have to have my second monitor have Minecraft on, so I can actually see what's going on. It's going to be interesting to actually try and do that. But, for now, we just want to get sort of this part done, and then the fishing village, which is something I really want to do, just because I want to move everyone down here. They won't be necessarily safe, though, which is the bad side, so maybe we want to change someone to an infantry, have them just sort of lay around here, not really do much. I'm not really worried about any matriarchs, because I did get one of them attack us, and, well, it was quite interesting, let's say that. Oh. He's waddling away. That's fine. We won't worry about that. Right. So if we just get our head around this. I kind of just want to mine this up because it needs to be 5 across. Actually, does it need to be 5 across? Yeah, it needs to be 5 across because otherwise we can't have a door in the center of it. So it's going to be quite difficult to do, but we will have it set up sort of along here. So if we just mine up what we've built right here. Like this. It means now we need miners. There we go. Good start. We need builders. Oh, wait, no. Now we need miners. Great. Now we want to go on this level here so they get it all. Go along here. Oh. We'll have to get rid of these lights as well because they'll be conflicting with the actual size of the towers. They're going to be slightly taller than these ones. But they're pretty much going to have the same design. Just slightly taller. Well, wider as well. So it's going to be interesting to look for. Well, look at. But it's definitely going to emphasize the fact that this is the front entrance. The other entrances are just side entrances. They are anyway, but need emphasis. Who the hell is this? Ralph Gerland. Wow. Why don't you get off your ass? There's beds over there. Why are you wasting your time? Oh, getting some mining done. Let's go back over here and set another designation. We want to mine that up as well. I want to go ahead and mine this up. Now, I did say I'd rather you not see all of this, but I think the back part was the part that was going to take the longest, just because it's harder to get to. Doing the front here, they seem to be getting the job done fairly quickly. Now, if we just go ahead and do this again. Of course, we're not actually done. I think we're quite far from it, simply because... Oh, we have all this to do as well. Simply because we need to go 5 down in order to get a 2 high moat. Because of how high up our castle actually is in comparison to the actual ground level of the water. But still, we can get it done. I'm not sure if I can get the water to go up, but I don't think that will be the case. There's no sort of water blocks that are any higher than the water that we have right here. So we won't be able to do that, by the looks of things anyway. Right, if we just go back and set our builders back into miners. Actually, no, we could... I believe one of the developers, FRL, did tell me that logs, if they're just one and then across, will look like they're going diagonally. It's just not diagonally, bloody horizontally. So let's just go ahead and actually try that. I'm not too sure where you get this. I imagine it's walls. I'm not too sure what it was. I believe it was logs. I can't remember off the top of my head. Timbered brick, nope, that's not the case. Full timber. No. What's full timber require? Yeah, it's just timber, isn't it? Maybe I'm looking in the wrong section. No, I would have thought it'd be in there, but apparently not. Roofing, nope. Flooring. No, okay, I'm not too sure. I can't remember exactly off the top of my head. I might be overlooking it though. Might have to go and double check that in a second. I should really write the comments down because I always forget. That's something I forget every single time. Hopefully I won't forget it in Prison Architect because there are a lot of things I do wrong on that. But that's fine. They'll be mining all that up. Good thing we didn't mine that up as well because we ended up not having the ability to find anything. Also, we should probably get a scavenger so they can actually gather up these bodies. There are a lot of spiders running around, but I'm not too sure I really mine too much. Now, I believe Z903 is a farmer right now, level 20 farm that is. But I don't mind them actually becoming a forager, going back to their roots and seeing what they can do. Now, I just want you to loot dead bodies. I know it sounds a little bit grim. Maybe hunt chicken as well. Chickens. So if you want to go ahead and go to these corpses over here and just, you know, gather the resources. Yeah, I like the idea of that. Gather resources. Go over to this guy as well. Now, there are quite a lot of spiders, like I just said. There are a lot, really. So we want to gather them up as well because we'll get some webs from them. Even though it doesn't make much of a difference because I believe... Oh, there are so many chickens. You know, don't hunt chicken. We'll get like a forager, a herder even, to actually gather them up. We can put them over here. That's a pretty good idea. Looking forward to having this fishing village, though. It's going to look pretty small at first. It's not really going to look like it's part of the town. But eventually, it is going to sprawl. It's going to become an amazing sort of place to live. So we've got Z903 with a lot of materials. A lot of animal hide, which is good to see. We do need a lot of animal hide in order to make significantly improved leather armor pieces. Of course, it's in the name. Look at all the holes. There's actually a big hole down here where a spider is living. I believe it's this one. Yep, there you go. That is absurd. We just get the full control right here. This is when he like pops out. Oh, that's creepy looking. There we go. Very strange. All right, if we just go to full mode. Wow, there's a lot of noise. There's a lot going on right now. They're nearly there. That looks really cool. If a little bit out of place. But it looks cool nonetheless. It looks like changing our people from builders to miners won't really make much of a difference now. Oh, wow, there's actually designations they've not actually got around to do anything with yet. That's fine. We'll mine that up. That's 7 across, isn't it? Yeah, okay, it looked like 6 or something then. Now, we will make some sort of chisel along here, the same height as this slab right here. I can't remember what this is called, flatstone. Yeah, we're going to make sort of a flatstone border, but I might make it out of wood, I'm not too sure, around this moat. I'm not too sure why exactly, but I feel like it's going to help pronunciate the moat. I don't know. I like the idea of having some sort of border around it. Safety first, ladies and gentlemen. That's definitely why I would have a border around it. As you can see, this is completely done. We're probably going to have to mine this wall out, though, by the looks of it, because these towers are going to be quite large, simply because there are 5 across. So if we go to walls, castle brick, trimless. Do we want to go trimless? Yeah, it looks like it. So we will go trimless. And at 5 across, there you are. As you can see, that is the middle right there. And then we want to just do a block right here. And then another 5. So as you can see, this is going to be a bit too big, actually. Yeah, that is going to be a bit too big. I mean, we'll be able to probably still do 3, but like open it up like that. No, that's too big as well. I guess we'll do 4. But that's going to look weird. See? That's a problem we have right now. We don't want to go sort of... Well, no, there's nothing really stopping us from going too big. It's just that we'll have to get rid of a lot of stuff that's around here because at the moment we don't have a lot of space. That's why it's a good idea to move all this stuff. Eventually, we're going to get the walls done as well. Might be something that we actually do today. That's a good point. I do need to get around to doing that. Probably the front walls, I think, would look pretty good once they've actually got a moat going on. They're probably going to be 4 up, so they're not going to be as tall as this tower, but probably pretty close. I'm not too sure if I want to put a door connected to this as well. That's not something I actually thought about in the planning, having doors connected to the towers. might be something we do. That would be the way for them to actually get up onto the wall. Yeah, that sounds like a good idea. We'll see what we can do about that. Right, if we actually go to construction and just stop whatever selection we've got here, and we actually just mine out these walls that we've got around here. There we go. Because we've not got enough space, unfortunately, so we will need to actually make some for ourselves. Getting rid of all these stonemason stockpiles is going to be the next step, and these weapon racks, because they will get in the way. I think these will get in the way as well, so we're going to watch out there. Got to be careful, watch out. Don't get in the way there, Johnson. Don't get killed. I don't know what the hell I'm talking about. So we'll make some masonry stockpiles. Where do we want them? Like, we could just have them hang around here where the old farm was. There we are. If we get that sorted out, I believe miners do that. That's good then. So we can get that leveled up, and then we could just delete these. Probably these mining carts as well. We might want to move them later on. I'm looking forward to making a blacksmith's as well. I'm not sure if I want to make it down here. Probably. Like, all the random utilities and stuff like that are going to be, like, professions and profession houses, guild houses, and stuff like that are going to be around the castle, not actually going to be inside it. The castle's just sort of the town center, if you will. But it's a really good one. It's going to have the sort of grand doors and everything like that. Grand doors? I mean, it's going to have a grand door, I suppose, but it's also going to have sort of a really nice-looking inside. Well, we'll have two tables and, I believe, 20 seats altogether. So, you know, only the grandest of people, once we get to a certain population, we'll actually be able to get in. We had 30 people last time on day 50-something, so, you know. Actually, I think it was further than that, but I can't remember. Islay can't remember, okay? She's not good with time. Don't worry about it. These are all built now, so we'll upgrade them. It's a very exciting time, though. We've got so much to do. It's fantastic. We've got the castle actually designed now. It's late afternoon already. Bloody hell. That was very quick. Oh. I will be right back for just a second. And we're back. There we go. Sorry about that. Anyway, as I was saying, something about so much that we have to do. Yeah. Something like that. You know, I'm not too sure. I've not really named what the districts are really going to be just yet, but I feel like, you know, this is going to be sort of the food area. I'm not too sure if maybe I want to designate them by what we have. So we have sort of the masonry guild, where we have the blacksmith, the masons, and the blacksmith, the masons, and the carpenters. Then we sort of have the food area, where, you know, all the, like, where the farm is, where all the fishing docks are, where the all the animals are penned. What else do we have? We should, like, base it on our professions, really. So we've got, like, a woodcutting area as well. I think that'll probably be in the farm area. We'll have some sort of really nice-looking orchard, but not orchard. I believe orchard is, named that because it's really for picking fruit and stuff. I may be mistaken. Right, if we just go 7 across. There's very loud noises. Let me just close the window. Right, beautiful. Oh. Anyway, we will continue on our adventure. So if we just go to professions right here. I should just go to U mode. Actually, I like the idea of going to the nice little images. Anyway, now I'm not too sure if the engineers should be... Oh, that's right, we need sort of a barracks, like a place where all the soldiers can go. Like soldiers and archers, where they can train, cool stuff like that. I'm not too sure if maybe I should have that in the castle, but I think it might be a good idea if we have a separate area for that. The traders. Yeah, Market Square, that'd be quite interesting, but I'm not too sure. Like, the Market Square can have the tailors. The traders, the tailors, and the, I guess, adventurers, but it doesn't really matter too much. Yeah, it looks like about it. We've used up most of our classes right here. Maybe the wood shoppers can go into the market area. That might be a good idea. I'm not sure how many districts I should really have now. We've got a lot of space, really. Like, we've got to remember that fact. Like, we might not even want to use all this bit up here. Like, this bit is enough. Like... Might be overstepping our boundaries too much. Or we could just use this area right here, which could work because we can set our sort of free areas. And then this sort of area right here doesn't really matter too much. It's just sort of random land. There's a lot we can do, which is fantastic. Right, we'll just upgrade these. Oh, wow. Everything is getting filled up very fast. If we go back to storage and just make our selected areas. Also, we want to make some new weapon racks. And I believe a carpenter makes that, exactly. So we'll just put them here for now. There we are. They'll be able to get them sorted out. Are you the carpenter? Looks like it. Yep, Cakeling, you are the carpenter. Fantastic. Just hoping to confirm that fact. If you want to make that one as well, that'd be really nice. Right, so these have been set up now by the looks of it, so we're just going to delete these. Beautiful. Now what we want to do is expand this land just a little bit. Because we want it to be leveled out. Since these towers are quite large, we might even need to go further than this. But we do need to get some stone sort of built up around here. Well, maybe not stone, but I want to get this out of the way so that when we build over it, it won't become an issue. This side's already dealt with, so we won't worry about that too much. So now if we go to walls, castle brick, it's a bit dark. Not much I can do about that, I'm afraid. So we got 5. And so now I'm wondering if we want to do this and then another 5. Oh, bloody hell. Of course we go a little bit too far and it's just this point. It's fine, we can mine through that anyway, but it's a little bit of a bother. Alright, go back to construction. Let's delete this because I'm not too sure if I made it chiseled or not and just forgot. Here we go, 5 across. And then we'll do this. Then we'll poke it out one more. Yeah, I knew these would get in the way. If we just delete them, because both the weapon racks should be done now. Even if they were, we don't need that much space, because we don't have too many weapons. Unless all the arrows go into the weapons, but at the moment it's not... Well, we've not found any issue with it. So this tower's very big. We got to definitely specify that fact. We can put some ballistas on here, though, so that's really nice. Definitely going to help us to specify the fact that this is the front gate, where the best defenses are. They're building it very quickly as well, which is nice to see. Right, so now if we go ahead and do the same thing on this side. It's not too big, so I'm not going to worry about it too much. But when we have it all done and built up, it's going to look pretty fantastic, I would think. I would think, okay? My mind is telling me it would look really nice. So we want to get the doorway sorted out first. So if we go ahead and just sort of mine this out. And do the same here. Oh, no, we want to have it on the level as well, because we're doing the same with this. So we sort of want it to go up by two. Two layers of a sort of stair. So if we just pause right here. Also, let's get some mining designated, just to keep them from, keep them working, you know? Know what I mean? Right. We should go down by one more. Should be 7 across. There we go, beautiful. We'll do the same here. I guess we'll go down a few layers. I'll be able to actually select it now. There we go. Beautiful. There we go. They'll get that bit done. Nice to see. It's all coming together. As you can see, it looks really nice right now, this moat. It's going to look even better once we actually get some water set up. That's going to look really good. Water. Get some water. Right. If we just zoom down right here. It's really dark. Bloody hell. It feels like it gets darker every time we play. Then again, the sun's sort of in my face right now, so it's making it really difficult for me to actually... Right, so right here... That didn't seem right. I guess we'll just do it from this layer. See, that isn't right. That's going down by 7. This ain't right either, I don't think. No, this is going down by 8. Why the hell that happen? Alright, we'll just get some construction done over there. I want it to be proper, you know? It needs to be... Oh, sand, not sand. Nearly there. Alright, we'll just go up by 2 there. We'll have them continue their nice little jobs right here. Bloody hell. I need to get some light sources sort of set up around these entire zones right here, because I just can't see a thing. Let's get some... What am I looking for right now? Can I give them all torches? Because I do remember one of them holding a torch. But I don't think it emitted any light, so I'm not too sure it's going to be much of a problem. If we just get you right here to actually hold a torch. I know we've got some in our inventory, so it should be alright. There we go. Torch. Now, I believe that they did hold the torch. But I may be mistaken. He's got this to do right now, so he's not really bothering. At least you build that up very quickly. Just double check that we actually have some torches in inventory. Yeah, we got 3. So I'm not too sure if it's you that have the torch. It probably is. I'm trying to select you right now. No, not you, Jared. It'd be you. Yeah, Radcliffe. Go on, Radcliffe. Grab that torch. There we go. He's got a torch. How much light does it really emit? A little bit. It's not really much of a difference. I mean, it helps us see where they are. So it'll be really useful if we have our forager have one of these when they're running around. But at the moment, I'm not too sure there's much point. So if we just get rid of that for now. We still need to get the bridge set up here. It's going to be bigger by the looks of it as well, just because these towers are much larger. I mean, yeah, that looked pretty good in my opinion, so I'm not too bothered about that. If we also, like, if we made the flooring out of wood. We made it out of stone. Okay, so if we just mine out the flooring layers right here. Actually, we don't need to, necessarily. If we just make them thick brick, that would work out. There we go. That's what we did with the other layers. And it should be, it'll be going up by 2, so should be all right. Also, these center bits right here need to be a different brick type. We need to get that sorted out. Same with here. That bit doesn't matter too much because it's connected to this. See, and the thing before was that these layers were actually going in between these bits. They were. So I'm wondering why I've not done that here. I think I like not doing that here because it definitely makes the castle gate right here look a bit different. Why do I always forget these little things? Ah, the sun! Get out of my face! I can't see shit! Ah, beautiful. Alright, so we got that layer mined out. We don't need to worry putting anything there because we won't be able to see it anyway. We need to mine this layer out. Beautiful. And this, not really. Because it's going to be a roof anyway. Which reminds me, we do need to get that set up. We go to roofing. There we go. Can't actually see it right now. There we go, so that bit's there. Beautiful. We just get rid of this hay pile. There we go. Now wheat is actually too high, of course it is. This hay pile right here needs to have a separate zone. Alright, so if I just go over to... I need to put like my brightness up on my monitor or something. But this game has brightness settings. We just go and find out. It might. It has light and rendering paths. No, okay. I kind of think it would be a good idea, but I'm not too sure just yet. But I definitely want to set this up as the farm. We can probably get some sort of... Well, I really want to get the wall set up. That's what I want to do. It's not too big, but I want to just have like 2 blocks so I know where the wall's going to be. Probably have to go over this block and we'll fill that in. But still, we've got quite a lot to do over here, so maybe we're getting a little bit too ambitious. If we go on this side and actually tell them to mine a little bit more... We're going 7 blocks away from the main castle itself. Oh, that's not right. I don't know why they missed that block, but that's fine. We'll mine that block up. And it's meant to be 3 blocks down. As you can see, that's how far the actual bridge goes, which is good. It looks good. We've got to get this done as well. Right, so as I was saying until I interrupted myself, fantastic, I do that a lot. We need to get another builder because I don't think 2's enough. I think 4's a good amount. So let's see, Farkas, level 5, yeah? Well, actually, no. We'll get Goddard right here to be a builder. And we'll get... Sniper's a good miner. We'll get Radcliffe to do it. There we go. So we've got 4 builders. We're going to get them set up on this sort of slightly bigger towers that are going to be set up right here. How big are they really going to be? See, now, I've tried to test this on the stream, because I did a live stream, 2 of them, on Minecraft, where I actually built the entire castle. And that's it looks pretty good, I would say. It'll probably look better on on timber and stone, because it's sort of made for it. But I'm looking forward to actually building that. I'm not too sure if I'm going to get much of that done today, because I'm going to have to look back on it and then look here. So I have to have my second monitor have Minecraft on, so I can actually see what's going on. It's going to be interesting to actually try and do that. But, for now, we just want to get sort of this part done, and then the fishing village, which is something I really want to do, just because I want to move everyone down here. They won't be necessarily safe, though, which is the bad side, so maybe we want to change someone to an infantry, have them just sort of lay around here, not really do much. I'm not really worried about any matriarchs, because I did get one of them attack us, and, well, it was, it was quite interesting, let's say that. Oh. He's waddling away. That's fine. We won't worry about that. Right. So if we just get our head around this. We kind of just want to mine this up because it needs to be 5 across. Actually, does it need to be 5 across? Yeah, it needs to be 5 across because otherwise we can't have a door in the center of it. So it's going to be quite difficult to do, but we will have it set up sort of along here. So if we just mine up what we've built right here. Like this. It means now we need miners. There we go. Good start. We need builders. Oh, wait, no. Now we need miners. Great. Now we want to go on this level here so they get it all. Go along here. Oh. We'll have to get rid of these lights as well because they'll be conflicting with the actual size of the towers. They're going to be slightly taller than these ones. But they're pretty much going to have the same design. Just slightly taller. Well, wider as well. So it's going to be interesting to look for. Well, look at. But it's definitely going to emphasize the fact that this is the front entrance. The other entrances are just side entrances. They are anyway, but need emphasis. Who the hell is this? Ralph Gerland. Wow. Why don't you get off your ass? There's beds over there. Why are you wasting your time? Oh, getting some mining done. Let's go back over here and set another designation. We want to dig. We want to mine that up as well. And want to go ahead and mine this up. Now, I did say I'd rather you not see all of this, but I think the back part was the part that was going to take the longest, just because it's harder to get to. Doing the front here, they seem to be getting the job done fairly quickly. Now, if we just go ahead and do this again. Of course, we're not actually done. I think we're quite far from it, simply because... Oh, we have all this to do as well. Simply because we need to go 5 down in order to get a 2 high moat. Because of how high up our castle actually is in comparison to the actual ground level of the water. But still, we can get it done. I'm not sure if I can get the water to go up, but I don't think that will be the case. There's no sort of water blocks that are any higher than the water that we have right here. So we won't be able to do that, by the looks of things anyway. Right, if we just go back and set our builders back into miners. Actually, no, we could... I believe one of the developers, FRL, did tell me that logs, if they're just one and then across, will look like they're going diagonally. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Nick of today, playing some Timber and Stone, Land of Islay, Season 3. Look at this. Fantastic. Merv's rattling around again. What a bastard. I just need to find a way to actually not hear what the fuck he's doing. Unfortunately, that would involve you not hearing my voice, which is a downside, I might add. That's sort of the point. So there we go. What did we do last episode? Well, last episode, we created ourselves this beautiful tower right here. I think this is exactly how it looked before. But what I've also done is I've created the tower on the other side and made sort of a little thing up here. And I've also replicated it on this side right here. I've also dug a moat at the back here, which I think needs to be 2 blocks lower, to be honest with you, because you can move this water. I did just test it right here. And they will move the water if you give it space to do so. So we'll need to actually make a path for the water to get down here, but unfortunately, it is 2 blocks down. If I just test it right here, like this is the water layer right here. If I just go down a level, Because you can't see it here, which means it won't go that far down. There you go. So we need to go sort of like one or two blocks down to really make the moat make sense. I would rather it just sort of be right here, but I can't do that. So at some point, we will have to just finish off making this moat by going down two more layers. It won't be too much of a bother, but we will need to actually get it done on this side as well. What we're going to do in this episode is just sort of building the moat a little bit more. Hopefully making some sort of fishing village and getting the farm moved over here. I like the idea of doing that. And I will be trying to make the front gate. It is going to be slightly bigger. That's the whole point we've got right here. Ow, Merv, what are you doing? What are you trying to do? I'd rather you be there than shouting in your cage. Now, we have run out of tools. For those that are wondering, I'm ill. So, it's getting very difficult to actually talk for extended periods of time without screwing up. It's kind of normal, really. Oh, God. Also, I'll be sniffling a lot. I'll be sniffing a lot of things. It's pretty fantastic. We're really running out of space right here. This is why we need the fishing village, so we can move a bunch of crap and then use this side. This is meant to be the courtyard, okay? We're not meant to have people in here. Something that we need to get around to doing is actually making the wall around this moat. I'm not too sure if I want to make it out of wood or stone or a bit of both. Probably a bit of both, but the thing is, I like the idea of making sort of a fairly large wall around the main keep that's made out of stone. But then again, I could use wood because they can still burn the stone anyway, the necromancers. So it will not make much of a difference. We found that out during the unfortunate events of the fight that did take place. Go to super speed mode. Also, we are running out of metal space apparently, which is interesting because I don't remember. Oh, I guess it was all the mining they did. You know, there's a lot of materials around here that we actually go ahead and gather, which is something we may go ahead and do. Also need to designate this. Oh, apparently there was a merchant that I missed. Don't worry about it. Who cares about that guy? Right, so we'll just get this mining done here. Beautiful. I'm going to try and find out how we're going to get this sorted out. So let's see, what builders do we have at our disposal? We've got Seaboy and Jared right here. Ephril's a good miner, so I'm going to leave you to that. Radcliffe Sutton right here, who is a new person. We have quite a lot of new people, I might add. You can definitely tell by their names that just sort of, they've got like a second name and a last, well, they got a first name and a last name, basically. Whereas our people are generally just given one name. So we got Radcliffe Sutton right here. We got Hill Jared Goddard. Fantastic. Francis Belmont. Oh, that's a fantastic name. Francis Belmont. Yeah, three new people. They're sort of either I've been given while making this, which was amazing, I might add. They just kept coming in. It was awesome. But we will need to actually give name to those people eventually. None of them are lazy. Sorry, Naria. Actually, I'm not too sure if they are lazy. We should go back on the list now that I think about it. We did get someone that was lazy, but I named them already, so I didn't want to make the person feel bad. Oh, wow, Liam. So we automatically click on the lazy person. Yeah, Liam. It was someone that requested to be named, I believe. Right, so let's see. Any lazy traits? Oh, yep, Liam again. I thought he just went past you. Does not look like it. Got clumsy, but that's not what we're looking for. Yep, Liam. So we got 17 people, I might add, in our land of Islay. Hopefully some more people come by and actually help us out. I'm not too sure if I want to mine this brick. This giant sort of slab of rock. Yeah, Market Square, that'd be quite interesting. But I'm not too sure. Like, the Market Square can have the tailors. The traders, the tailors, and the, I guess, adventurers, but it doesn't really matter too much. Yeah, it looks like about it. We've used up most of our classes right here. Maybe the wood shoppers can go into the market area. That might be a good idea. I'm not sure how many districts I should really have now. We've got a lot of space, really. Like, we got to remember that fact. Like, we might not even want to use all this bit up here. Like, this bit is enough. Like, might be overstepping our boundaries too much. Or we could just use this area right here, which could work because we can set our sort of free areas. And then this sort of area right here doesn't really matter too much. It's just sort of random land. There's a lot we can do, which is fantastic. Right, we'll just upgrade these. Oh, wow, everything is getting filled up very fast. If we go back to storage and just make our selected areas. Also, we want to make some new weapon racks. And I believe a carpenter makes that, exactly. So we'll just put them here for now. There we are. They'll be able to get them sorted out. Are you the carpenter? Looks like it. Yep, Cakeling, you are the carpenter. Fantastic. Just hoping to confirm that fact. If you want to make that one as well, that'd be really nice. Right, so these have been set up now by the looks of it, so we're just going to delete these. Beautiful. Now what we want to do is expand this land just a little bit. Because we want it to be leveled out. Since these towers are quite large, we might even need to go further than this. But we do need to get some stone sort of built up around here. Well, maybe not stone, but I want to get this out of the way so that when we build over it, it won't become an issue. This side's already dealt with, so we won't worry about that too much. So now if we go to walls, castle brick, it's a bit dark. Not much I can do about that, I'm afraid. So we got 5. So now I'm wondering if we want to, do this and then another 5. Oh, bloody hell. Of course we go a little bit too far and it's just this point. It's fine, we can mine through that anyway, but it's a little bit of a bother. Alright, go back to construction. Let's delete this because I'm not too sure if I made it chiseled or not and just forgot. Here we go, 5 across. And then we'll do this. Then we'll poke it out one more. Yeah, I knew these would get in the way. If we just delete them, because both the weapon racks should be done now. Even if they were, we don't need that much space because we don't have too many weapons. Unless all the arrows go into the weapons, but at the moment it's not. We've not found any issue with it. So this tower's very big. We got to definitely specify that fact. We can put some ballistas on here though, so that's really nice. Definitely going to help us to specify the fact that this is the front gate where the best defenses are. They're building it very quickly as well, which is nice to see. Alright, so now if we go ahead and do the same thing on this side. It's not too big, so I'm not going to worry about it too much. But when we have it all done and built up, it's going to look pretty fantastic, I would think. I would think, okay? My mind is telling me it would look really nice. So we want to get the doorway sorted out first. So if we go ahead and just sort of mine this out and do the same here. Oh no, no, we want to have it on a level as well because we're doing the same with this. So we sort of want it to go up by two. Two layers of a sort of stair. So if we just pause right here. Also, let's get some mining designated just to keep them from, keep them working, you know? Know what I mean? Right. We should go down by one more. Should be 7 across. There we go. Beautiful. We'll do the same here. I guess we'll go down a few layers. I'll be able to actually select it now. There we go. Beautiful. There we go. They'll get that bit done. Nice to see. It's all coming together. As you can see, it looks really nice right now, this moat. It's going to look even better once we actually get some water set up. That's going to look really good. Water. Get some water. Right. If we just zoom down right here. It's really dark. Bloody hell. It feels like it gets darker every time we play. It's just not diagonally. Bloody horizontally. So let's just go ahead and actually try that. I'm not too sure where you get this. I imagine it's walls. I'm not too sure what it was. I believe it was logs. I can't remember off the top of my head. Timbered brick. Nope, that's not the case. Full timber. No. What's full timber require? Yeah, it's just timber, isn't it? Maybe I'm looking in the wrong section. No. I would have thought it'd be in there, but apparently not. Roofing. Nope. Flooring. No, okay. I'm not too sure. I can't remember exactly off the top of my head. I might be overlooking it though. Might have to go and double check that in a second. I should really write the comments down because I always forget. That's something I forget every single time. Hopefully I won't forget it in Prison Architect because... Because there are a lot of things I do wrong on that. But that's fine. They'll be mining all that up. Good thing we didn't mine that up as well. Because we ended up not having the ability to find anything. Also, we should probably get a scavenger so they can actually gather up these bodies. There are a lot of spiders running around, but I'm not too sure I really mind too much. Now, I believe Z903 is a farmer right now, level 20 farm, that is. But I don't mind them actually becoming a forager, going back to their roots, and seeing what they can do. Now, I just want you to loot dead bodies. I know it sounds a little bit grim. Maybe hunt chicken as well. Chickens. So if you want to go ahead and go to these corpses over here, and just, you know, gather the resources. Yeah, I like the idea of that. Gather resources. Go over to this guy as well. Now, there are quite a lot of spiders, like I just said. There are a lot, really. So we want to gather them up as well, because we'll get some webs from them. Even though it doesn't make much of a difference, because I believe... Oh, there are so many chickens. You know, don't hunt chicken. We'll get, like, a forager, a herder even, to actually gather them up. We can put them over here. That's a pretty good idea. Looking forward to having this fishing village, though. It's going to look pretty small at first. It's not really going to look like it's part of the town. But eventually, it is going to sprawl. It's going to become an amazing sort of place to live. So we've got Z903 with a lot of materials. A lot of animal hide, which is good to see. We do need a lot of animal hide in order to make significantly improved leather armor pieces. Of course, it's in the name. Look at all the holes. There's actually a big hole down here where a spider is living. I believe it's this one. Yep, there you go. That is absurd. We just get the full control right here. This is when he like pops out. Oh, that's creepy looking. There we go. Very strange. Alright, if we just go to full mode. Wow, there's a lot of noise. There's a lot going on right now. They're nearly there. That looks really cool. If a little bit out of place. But it looks cool nonetheless. It looks like changing our people from builders to miners won't really make much of a difference now. Oh wow, there's actually designations they've not actually got around to do anything with yet. That's fine. We'll mine that up. That's 7 across, isn't it? Yeah, okay, it looked like 6 or something then. Now we will make some sort of chisel along here, the same height as this slab right here. I can't remember what this is called, flat stone. Yeah, we're gonna make sort of a flat stone border, but I might make it out of wood, I'm not too sure, around this moat. I'm not too sure why exactly, but I feel like it's gonna help pronunciate the moat. I don't know, I like the idea of having some sort of border around it. Safety first, ladies and gentlemen, that's definitely why I would have a border around it. As you can see, this is completely done. We're probably going to have to mine this wall out, though, by the looks of it, because these towers are going to be quite large, simply because they are 5 across. So if we go to walls, castle brick, trimless. Do we want to go trimless? Yeah, it looks like it. So we will go trimless. And at 5 across, there you are. As you can see, that is the middle right there. And then we want to just do a block right here. And then another 5. So as you can see, this is going to be a bit too big, actually. Yeah, that is going to be a bit too big. I mean, we'll be able to probably still do 3, but, like, open it up like that. Nah, that's too big as well. I guess we'll do 4. But that's going to look weird, see? That's a problem we have right now. We don't want to go sort of... Well, no, there's nothing really stopping us from going too big. It's just that we'll have to get rid of a lot of stuff that's around here, because at the moment we don't have a lot of space. That's why it's a good idea to move all this stuff. Eventually, we're going to get the walls done as well. Might be something that we actually do today. That's a good point. I do need to get around to doing that. Probably the front walls, I think, would look pretty good once they've actually got a moat going on. They're probably going to be 4 up, so they're not going to be as tall as this tower, but probably pretty close. I'm not too sure if I want to put a door connected to this as well. That's not something I actually thought about in the planning, having doors connected to the towers. Might be something we do. That'll be the way for them to actually get up onto the wall. Yeah, that sounds like a good idea. We'll see what we can do about that. Right, if we actually go to construction and just stop whatever selection we've got here, and we actually just mine out these walls that we've got around here. There we go. Because we've not got enough space, unfortunately, so we will need to actually make some for ourselves. Getting rid of all these stonemason stockpiles is going to be the next step, and these weapon racks, because they will get in the way. I think these will get in the way as well, so we're going to watch out there. Got to be careful, watch out. Don't get in the way there, Johnson. Don't get killed. I don't know what the hell I'm talking about. So we'll make some masonry stockpiles. Where do we want them? Like, just have them hang around here where the old farm was. There we are. If we get that sorted out, I believe miners do that. That's good then. So we can get that leveled up, and then we could just delete these. Probably these mining carts as well. We might want to move them later on. I'm looking forward to making a blacksmith's as well. I'm not sure if I want to make it down here. Probably. Like, all the random utilities and stuff like that are going to be, like, professions and profession houses, guild houses, and stuff like that are going to be around the castle. They're not actually going to be inside it. The castle's just sort of the town center, if you will. But it's a really good one. It's going to have the sort of grand doors and everything like that. Grand doors? I mean, it's going to have a grand door, I suppose, but it's also going to have sort of a really nice-looking inside. Well, we'll have two tables and, I believe, 20 seats altogether. So, you know, only the grandest of people, once we get to a certain population, will actually be able to get in. We had 30 people last time on day 50-something, so, you know. Actually, I think it was further than that, but I can't remember. Islay can't remember, okay? She's not good with time. Don't worry about it. These are all built now, so we'll upgrade them. It's a very exciting time, though. We've got so much to do. It's fantastic. We've got the castle actually designed now. It's late afternoon already. Bloody hell. That's very quick. Oh. I will be right back for just a second. And we're back. There we go. Sorry about that. Anyway, as I was saying, something about so much that we have to do. Yeah. Something like that. You know, I'm not too sure. I've not really named what the districts are really going to be just yet. But I feel like, you know, this is going to be sort of the food area. I'm not too sure if maybe I want to designate them by what we have. So we have sort of like the masonry guild, where we have the blacksmith, the masons, and the carpenters. Then we sort of have the food area, where, you know, all the, like, where the farm is, where all the fishing docks are, where the all the animals are penned. What else do we have? We should, like, base it on our professions, really. So we've got, like, a woodcutting area as well. I think that'll probably be in the farm area. We'll have some sort of really nice-looking orchard, but not orchard. I believe orchard is, named that because it's really for picking fruit and stuff. I may be mistaken. All right, if we just go 7 across. There's very loud noises. Let me just close the window. Right, beautiful. Oh. Anyway, we will continue on our adventure. So if we just go to professions right here. I should just go to U mode. Actually, I like the idea of going to the nice little images. Anyway, now I'm not too sure if the engineers should be... Oh, that's right. We need sort of a barracks, like a place where all the soldiers can go. Like soldiers and archers, where they can train, cool stuff like that. I'm not too sure if maybe I should have that in the castle, but I think it might be a good idea if we have a separate area for that. The traders,